My name is Chen Yi. I will discuss a journal article on the role of progesterone in prevention of preterm labor and neonatal morbidity in twin gestation. The outline of the presentation will be as follows. First, I will talk about the background of this research paper. Then I will talk about the paper itself, the methods, results, and discussion. Then a meta-analysis of the current literature and a conclusion. Preterm birth affects about 15% of singleton and 60% of twin gestations. Twin pregnancies are at higher risk for spontaneous preterm delivery, lower birth weight, higher neonatal morbidities and mortality. So far, progesterone has been found to promote uterine quiescence and prevent cervical ripening. Research has shown that antenatal progestogens are successful in preventing preterm birth in select high-risk singleton pregnancies, particularly in women with a short cervix or previous history of preterm birth. So the clinical question is progestogen treatment effective for preventing preterm birth or adverse perinatal outcomes in twin pregnancies? The paper of our focus is entitled A Randomized Controlled Double-Blinded Clinical Trial of 17-Hydroxyprogesterone Caprolate for the Prevention of Preterm Birth in Twin Gestation. It was published in 2014 in the British Journal of Obstetrics and Gynecology. Extrapolating from the well-demonstrated benefit of progesterone in singleton pregnancy, the authors wanted to find out if progestogen had similar effect in twin gestation. So they designed this randomized controlled double-blind trial to evaluate the efficacy of weekly 250 mg injections of 17-hydroxyprogesterone caprolate compared with placebo for preventing preterm birth in unselected twin pregnancies. The inclusion criteria were twin pregnancy diagnosed by ultrasound and maternal age more than 18 years old. The exclusion criteria were ultrasonographically diagnosed fetal anomalies, elective cervical cerclage, hypertension, diabetes mellitus, asthma, history of deep vein thrombosis, history of hepatic disease or abnormal liver enzymes, pre-existing renal disease or abnormal kidney function, as well as seizures disorders. Eligible women were recruited at 12 to 20 weeks of gestation. Weekly intramuscular injections of progesterone or placebo were given from 16 to 36 weeks of gestation, and there are follow-up until delivery. This trial monitored two things. One, the primary clinical outcome was preterm birth rate prior to 37 weeks of gestation. Two, the secondary clinical outcome was early preterm birth, low birth weight, neonatal morbidity such as respiratory distress syndrome, sepsis, intraventricular hemorrhage, necrotizing enterocolitis, retinopathy or prematurity, perinatal mortality, and maternal morbidity like gestational diabetes, pregnancy-induced hypertension, and preterm premature rupture of membrane. The addition of progestin did not result in significant difference between the study and placebo group in the rate of preterm birth before 37 weeks of gestation, as well as the mean gestational age at delivery between the two groups, 35.1 weeks in the progesterone group and 34.6 weeks in the placebo group. Kaplan-Meier survival analysis of the proportion of undelivered pregnancies throughout weeks of gestation show no significant difference between the two groups. There is a significant increase in the mean birth weight in the treatment group, 2.28 kg, compared to placebo group, 2.14 kg. Progesterone-treated neonates had almost 30% reduction in composite neonatal morbidity, 19.1%. Compared to placebo, 30.9%. Most significantly, lower odds for respiratory distress syndrome, retinopathy of prematurity, and sepsis. Subgroup analysis by chorionicity suggested no significant difference between bichorionic and monochorionic twins in the rate of preterm birth and composite neonatal morbidity. In terms of maternal morbidity, the incidence of pregnancy-related complications such as gestational diabetes, pregnancy-induced hypertension, preterm premature rupture membrane, and chorioamnionitis was similar in both groups. The efficacy of progestogen therapy has been well documented in selected high-risk singleton pregnancies, but several trials have failed to demonstrate similar benefit in twin pregnancies. In a paper authored by Rouse et al., showed that progesterone did not reduce the rate of preterm birth in twin gestations. Also, the STOP-IT trial showed higher incidence of preterm birth in twin pregnancy treated with vaginal progesterone. Then, what explains the differential effect of 17-hydroxyprogesterone caprate in singleton and twin pregnancies? One is that there could be different mechanisms of labor in singleton versus twin pregnancies, or cervical ripening may not be primary contribution in the pathogenesis of preterm birth in twin pregnancy. People have postulated uterine overdistension as the possible mechanism for preterm labor in twin pregnancy. In vitro studies show that progesterone does not inhibit stretch receptor-related gene expression in human myometrial cells. This could be a possible explanation that progesterone is ineffective in preventing preterm labor in twin gestations. The take-home messages of this presentation are the following. Preterm birth is associated with high-risk perinatal mortality and morbidity. Progesterone is effective in preventing preterm birth and improving neonatal outcome in selected high-risk singleton pregnancy. This study has shown that progesterone does not prevent preterm birth, but nonetheless significantly improves perinatal outcome and birth weight in unselected twin pregnancy. Currently, there is no effective intervention to prevent preterm birth in twins. Here are the references. Thank you for watching Learning in 10.